What's up, guys? I'm Reckless, and welcome to Guardian Watcher. So, it's finally happening. Today, we are going to do a review on the legend in the making, the Trials of the Nine Slayer, the King of Scout Rifles, the Mita Multi-Tool. Now, I have been holding off on this video for quite some time due to wanting this as the very first exotic review that I do for the new updated channel, and the reason for that being is because I hold the Mita Multi-Tool very dear to my heart. But enough about me. Let's get into the weapon stats and see why it is king. So, the Mita Multi-Tool has an RPM of 200, which makes it one of the fastest shooting scout rifles. It has an impact of 60, a range of 42, a stability of 37, reload speed of 82, and a handling of 82 as well. As for its hidden stats, there is a zoom of 20, an inventory size of 60, an aim assist that is maxed out at 100, god damn, and a recoil direction of 80. Now I see why this thing is freaking OP. Whoops. I'm sorry. I can't say that. The children get very angry when us YouTubers say OP. So, in that regards, this weapon is just plain old spectubular. Yeah, I said it. Hate on it if you want. The Mita has changed from Destiny 1 to Destiny 2, and dramatically. Even though it may look identical, there are still small changes. In Destiny 1, we had way more options in the sense of perks to choose from, but unfortunately, in Destiny 2, Bungie gave all the exotic and some legendary weapons set perks on those weapons. Now, a few of its perks are the same and others are different. Speaking of the perks, let's get into the perks for the Mita in D2. For the intrinsic perk, we have Mita Multi-Tool, which this weapon boosts move speed. Should have just said movement speed. Next, we have Corkscrew Rifling, our wonderful high caliber rounds, Mita Radar, as well as Hand-Laid Stock. And mine currently has the All Essentials ornament on it, which pretty much makes it white. So that's what it looks like when it's actually not on. I think it looks retarded though. So we're just going to go ahead and put that back on. Now, this gun and I, well, we have history. I have been using this thing ever since it came out in Destiny 1 Year 1. I have went flawless many times in the Trials of Osiris with my Sunsinger, RIP, in Destiny 1 with the Mita, and my first two flawless runs in the Trials of the Nine were with the Mita as well, before it was recognized as the best gun in this current meta. If you guys would like to watch any of those videos, then I will put them in the description below. Now, attacking with the Mita is easy. Just keep on those headshots. But, how do you actually defend against the Mita? Well, as of this current meta, if you are able to set your character up as a 1-4-10 in your armor stats, then you have a fighting chance. That's 1 mobility, 4 resilience, and 10 recovery. It's hard to do with a Titan and a Hunter, but it is possible with the Warlock. And that's how I have my Warlock set up. In order to achieve this as a Warlock, you need an Impact Absorption mod. Mine happens to be in my helmet, as well as a self-repairing mod, which also happens to be in my boots. Even though I have 1 mobility, my clan says that I am the fastest warlock in the clan when we do the raid while we are doing the gauntlet. This is probably because mobility only affects walking and strafing, while it does not, and I repeat, it does not affect your running. But getting back to the point, 4 resilience is high enough to force your opponent to have to take an extra shot in order to kill you. So instead of 3 headshots, they need 4. Having 5 or 6 resilience is pretty much a waste because it still would only take 4 headshots to kill you. 7 to 10 resilience takes 4 headshots and a body shot, so I kind of feel like that's a waste. Now, I know 1 headshot isn't a lot, but in a dire moment, that can decide who survives and pretty much who dies. Having high recovery is just as good because it'll help you get back into the fight a lot sooner. And we all know when you're a warlock, you want to get in and get out as fast as possible. Now, most of us know that the Curse of Osiris Expansion 1 is coming December 5th, 2017. And most likely, a sandbox update will come with it. So, after the sandbox update, the Mita may not be king any longer, or at least not in Trials of the Nine. Then again, Mita wasn't really the most talked about weapon in Destiny 1, so I wouldn't be surprised if it doesn't get nerfed this time around. Don't get me wrong, it was very, very good in Destiny 1, but it was like at the bottom half of the top tier weapons in D1. I still used it though, and when I found out it was coming back in D2, I was livid. So, with all of that said, I hope this review helped you guys a little bit, and let me know what you guys think of the infamous Mita Multitool. Do you love using it? Do you wish it gets nerfed to the ground? Or do you prefer to use other scout rifles like the Nameless Midnight, from which I have a review coming soon for that, so stay tuned. And that, fellow Guardians, brings us to the end. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like and share it, subscribe, and turn on notifications for more Destiny content. Feedback is always appreciated. Thank you guys for all of your support. And remember, less guns doesn't mean less crime. And I will see you guys next time.